You don't know when the time is coming. 3 days ago, one of my students, he was involved in a motorbike accident. He was lucky to survive. His cousin's still on life support machine. Like this, this is what life is. All of a sudden, his life support machine, they took it off today. He wasn't breathing still. Tomorrow's his last day. If he's not going to breathe after they take the life support machine off, he's finished. We're going to be leaving this Dabu Janaza. In the same way, we don't know when we're going to go. We don't know when we're going to go. And this same dua, which the Prophet said, it's a weapon, sirahul mu'min. It's a weapon for the mu'min. We have left it. Sayyidina Muhammad bin Habib, who was a qadi on Medina Sharif, he was walking amongst the people of Medina, looking if they're okay. A drought occurred in Medina Sharif. A drought occurred. And he saw an old man sitting next to a pillar. And this old man, his hair was all over the place. His clothes, they were patched up. His clothes were not ironed. He didn't see Shaykh Muhammad bin Habib. He put his hands up and he says, Ya Rabbi, the love you have for me, send down rain for the people of Medina. Listen to the words. For the love you have for me, send down rain for the people of Medina. As soon as he put his hands down, clouds started gathering and it started raining. This was his dua. He went home. Shaykh Muhammad bin Habib, rahmatullahi alayhi, he went following him, went to his house, knocked on the door. And he came inside and he said, Shaykh, you should have told me I would have come to see you. I would have come to see you. He says, but tell me one thing. You made the dua that Ya Rabbi, the love you have for me, send down rain for the people of Medina. He says, okay, we can say that, you know, for the love I have for you, Ya Rabbi. But why did you say for the love you have for me? What did he say? He says, I've got nothing. But wallahi, the best time in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just before Fajr prayer. And somebody every day comes and wakes me up at that time. And this is why I know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves me. Because when nobody's praying, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has appointed somebody to wake me up. Come, wake up. Come and worship me. When everybody else is fast asleep, somebody has been appointed to wake me. This is why I know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves me. Now, looking at the shafqat, looking at the compassion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how much he would give if somebody asked him. This is Sayyidina Anas radiallahu anhu. He reported that somebody came from a faraway tribe, having accepted Islam. He asked for some goats from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kept on giving goats until they said there were so many. He was shocked, this person. He was so shocked that he went back to his people. He says, become Muslim. For wallahi, this person called Muhammad, he does not fear poverty. This was the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Another incident, the Sahabiyat, they loved the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a lot. They came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with a piece of cloth saying, Ya Rasulullah, this is a gift from me to you. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to use this cloth as a kilt, as a diamond. We don't use diamond here, but if you go to Yemen, everybody uses it. If you're wearing normal trousers, they look at you. What is he doing? In Yemen, everybody wears it. When I first got there, everybody knew I'm new because of the trousers I was wearing. So everybody wears diamond there. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam finished from Zuhur prayer or whatever they were doing in the masjid. And one of the companions comes to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, Ya Rasulullah, I want that diamond, I want that kilt off you. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam goes into his room and he comes back having changed and he says, here, this is for you. The Sahaba say, Ya Fulan, did you not know that that was the only diamond that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had in his possession? He says, wallahi, I knew this. But the only reason I took the diamond from him is because I wanted this same diamond to be my kafan. This is the love for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when we see the tabi'een, they used to go to Sayyidina Anas radiallahu anhu and kiss his eyes. Not only kiss his eyes, but kissed his hands also. Why? Because they would say that these are the same eyes that have seen the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These are the same hands that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has touched. They used to kiss them. In Riyad al-Salihin, one of the hadith, a beautiful hadith, they say two Jews, they were best of friends. So one Jew went to the other saying, look, this Nabi's come here, let's go question him. Maybe he's the chosen one. And so they both went. They came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, asking the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about nine signs. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned each one by one. And when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam finished, they said, you are a prophet. Not only did they do that, they started kissing the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam hands and feet. This is the love they had for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And when we look at ourselves, and the way we're following the religion, that's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made dua for us. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made dua for us. That we do not know who he is. We will only realize who he is on the Day of Judgment, when he's running around everywhere, telling people, Ya Rabbi, forgive him. Ya Rabbi, forgive him. For he is from my ummati. He is my ummati. Forgive him. And what are we doing for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Are we coming to the masjid to learn the religion? The Shaykh Sa'ad, who's teaching every week here on Fridays, 8 o'clock, about the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How can you love somebody when you don't know about him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam? You know, we love such and such a football team. We're uncritical supporters. We know the team is not doing good, but still we say, oh, okay, they beat this team this season though. Don't we say that? When it comes to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when somebody says, okay, mention one miracle of the Prophet, can we mention one? Can we mention a miracle of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? The answer is no, unfortunately. Why? Because we're not reading about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We have few here that are teaching about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And why are we not seeking knowledge from them? There's Sheikh Wajid is teaching about the companions. I'm teaching myself in Madri Mosque. And come. We went out to learn the religion. We came out to teach you guys, not to teach the world. We came to teach you guys. So come on. Come and say, inshallah, I'm presenting myself to you, Ya Rasulullah. In this month when you are born, I'm presenting myself. Khalas. Be these people of truth. Be these people of reality. Don't be people of like, no, pretenders like myself. Be people of reality. Seek knowledge from the feet of the ulama. Who have seeked knowledge from the feet of the tabi'in, from the feet of Rasulullah. Have this yearning to know about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala move our hearts towards the religion. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala change our states in a good state. In a state when we pass away, we'll be smiling, inshaAllah ta'ala. وَمَا تَوْفِيكِ وَاَعْتِسَالِ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ وَعَفُ مِنْكُمْ.
MashaAllah. MashaAllah.
MashaAllah.